deviation. The police are watching them, stopping them. Like the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that I am like the one that I am like the one who has built a fire. I am like the one who has built the fire. And the moths or the people are racing towards it. And I'm trying to hold you and pull you back, but you are getting the better of me. That's what those people are like. The police are there, trying to prevent them from shirk. But they stand there and they turn towards the grave, hoping that they're not being watched. And they lower their head. Put their hands, most of them, below their navels or by their side. Because they believe that the Wahhabi way to pray is to put hands on the chest. And they'll just sit there or stand there facing the grave of the Messenger of Allah. And if they know that the police are inside, they'll go around the outside of the building. So even in a land where the rulers are preventing shirk, not a single church is to be found in this land. Not a single synagogue. Not a single Hindu temple. Not a single Sikh temple. Not a single Buddhist temple is found in this land of Tawheed. This is the land that they want to destroy. You ask any Kharji, despicable individual, which is their greatest enemy, they'll say the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia and King Fahd. He's the one that we need to remove first. They ignore the shirk in their own lands. In Egypt, in Pakistan, in Bangladesh, in Afghanistan. The graves that the people have built, put lights upon them, making it look like a Christmas tree. Traveling thousands of miles, we get letters in England from India. You are invited to the grave of so and so to come and spend 3 days here. Any wish that you have, write it down on paper, send £50 with it, and your wish will be granted. You send it off, you get a letter back. Your money wasn't enough, so your wish ain't granted. We need another 50. And you want to take jizya? Most of the ummah is upon this. How many people there are in the lands of the Muslims and in the lands of the West? From Morocco to Egypt to Sudan to Somalia to India to Pakistan to Malaysia to Indonesia. People who believe in superstitious charms. People who practice fortune telling. People who go to the awliya to make them, or go to their various sheikhs. Follow the Sufi tariqah, believing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is everywhere. How many people are there? This is kufr akbar, believing Allah is everywhere. How are you going to establish tawheed? You're going to kick out the Jews, they're mushriks. They're kuffar, la shak. You're going to replace them, what, with another set of mushriks? Who believe that Allah is inside of the pig and the donkey and the monkey? Like the Sufis do? Like the likes of Nuha Min Kela and his madhab? You want to replace the Jews with them? One form of shirk with another form of shirk? Establish tawheed. Tasfiyah wa tarbiyah. Purify the religion. Cultivate your children upon it. And then you watch, Allah will give you what He gave to the companions. If not to you, to your children. Not to your children, to the generation after. But He will come. Nuh alayhi salam, 950 years he strived to call the people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the worship of Allah. And then what? Did he overpower the state? Is that what you did, like Muhammad Sarur says? The Mubtadi'? Did he now, after 950 years, did he say, oh Allah, allow me to overtopple this ruler so I can become the ruler? Or did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send down the floods? And he went upon his ark and off with a handful of believers after 950 years. So, how is the striving? You may not see the fruits. Because the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not see the Maghrib conquered. He did not see India conquered. He did not see China conquered. He didn't see Spain conquered. But he was conquered. He didn't see those fruits. But he was conquered due to what he began, alayhi salatu wassalam. So don't worry about the Jews, worry about the Muslims right now. Because Allah has already told you about the Jews in the Quran. You want to know about the Jews? Read the Quran. Read it more often. And you learn more about them. You want to know about the Christians, the plots of the Christians? Read the Quran. You know more about them. Read the seerah of the Messenger of Allah. You know more about them. You don't need to watch CNN and ABC and NBC and this one and that one and Time Magazine and Newsweek and all this rubbish. You want to know about the plots of Jews and Christians? They ain't teaching you nothing new. What Allah didn't tell you 1400 years ago. What have you learned new from the plots of the Jews? The Jews, they tried to kill the Messenger, they tried to poison him. Some of the writers of Seerah, they even said that the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was killed due to the poison. Some of them, they say this. Due to the poisoning. So what do you want to know about the Jews? Some of them, the woman tried to kill the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Look what they did at the Battle of the Khandaq. And he had to go to Banu Qurayza. And he executed some of the writers of the Seerah, say up to 700 of the Jews. You want to know the plots of the Jews? Well, is that the problem of the Muslims today? The Jews and America and the Zionist plot and the Freemasons and whatever else and the blue beret, the Dajjals or Gog and Magog or whatever else they call them. You reckon that's the problem? When Juj wa Majuj appear, hope and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you're not around at that time. Because the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because they're going to come after the Dajjal. And the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa sallam used to seek refuge from the Dajjal. And the Dajjal is a real person, not a television in the corner.